morning, good afternoon, good night, wherever you're watching this from. Welcome to Assam Live. This is Assam Sports on this bright, beautiful Monday. Summer is here, and this is the time and space where the international tournaments take place. The Euro 2024 has taken center stage. A heat wave has swept across the globe. The beautiful game of football and soccer is always in motion and locomotion, and the Euros 2024 has lived up to its billing and more. Thank you for tuning in to Assam Sports, coming off an action-packed weekend of football and soccer, where it could have been one of the most saddest days in English football history. History was still made. Jude Bellingham being the youngest player to get an equalizing goal in the Euros at the dying minute, on the 94th minute, is when it took for Jude Bellingham to get a bicycle kick for England to take the game to extra time, where Harry Kane got a header and they won against Little Slovakia. And if you watch the game, it was a sad sight for over 90 minutes. The Slovakians were the better team. That was the worst English performance I have seen in my life. That was their worst performance in this tournament. And it took a miracle from Jude Bellingham to get them through. But conversation and just the reports circulating after the press conference, where Jude Bellingham was saying positive things about the team, said about how they played well and they created chances. I think Jude Bellingham was watching a different game, or he was playing in a different game, because he looked like they were lost. The entire English squad looked like they didn't have no tactic. They didn't know what to do. There was no game plan. And I saw a press conference where Gareth Southgate is trying to take credit for the Ivan Toney substitution. What a delusional world these people live in, where he's trying to take credit and he was saying he always knew they were going to win. Really? Against Slovakia? And if Ivan Toney was supposed to be the game changer, why wait till the 90th minute to bring him on? It is clear. I mean, there's no doubt around the fact that Gareth Southgate doesn't have a game plan. He doesn't have a tactical astuity to truly manage this team. That is clear for all to see. But the players on the field, the performance that they also put up, you could say maybe the likes of, when Cole Palmer came on, it was clear for all to see. So why he doesn't start Cole Palmer? We are all dumbfounded by it. Is he just dumb? Is there a thinking behind it that we don't know? Is he going to still play the same squad? Bukayo Saka, I didn't know whether he was playing left back or left wing back. I mean, Kyle Walker, the defense. We've had conversations about the offensive and how they are being a shadow of themselves. Saka, Harry Kane, Jude Bellingham. But the defense, the English defense, and even now that Gay Hodder got a yellow card and he's going to miss the next game. Who is going to come for this English defense? Luke Shaw? Look, it was sad for me to watch that game. The Slovakians, I don't feel so bad for them, because it almost felt like they also didn't believe what was going on. So because they could have won that game. And if you held on, why wait to the 94th minute to give it up? Jude Bellingham had all the space to kick a bicycle kick. Look, I'd rather see England in the tournament for entertainment factor, but also the competitiveness they bring. But they are playing against Switzerland next, and this Swiss team has proven to be solid with Akanji and Granit Xhaka and the young kids up forward. I just feel like Gareth Southgate is not the man for the job. I don't see England going all the way. France is playing now as we speak against Belgium, a 0-0 draw. Halftime later on in the day, Portugal is playing against Slovenia. The other slow Slovakia is out. They were kicked out by England over the weekend, 2-1 in extra time. Switzerland also beat Italy. That was inevitable. Everybody saw that coming. The Italians having been great in a controversial game with calls of penalties and handballs. Germany, the host nation, were able to beat Denmark 2-0. Spain, the most dominant team so far in the season, the tournament's favorites. Everybody tipped them to go to the final. Spain were able to beat Georgia 5-1. Today, later on in the day, Cristiano Ronaldo's Portugal is playing against Slovenia. France and Belgium just concluded halftime 0-0. Romelu Lukaku, the French are onslaught of attack. The Belgians are barely holding on. Mbappe had some chances. Tchouaméni also had some chances. The French look good, but they still are not as clinical as most people think they could be. They get into the box and the decision making is lacking. Are the French going to be able to beat the Belgians? The Euro 2024 is here to stay. Thank you for tuning in to Assem Sports. Gareth Southgate's England, a Jude Bellingham miracle is what saved them. It was a very sad game. Do you think England would change formation and maybe that almost losing and almost getting kicked out at the round of 16, is that going to put some battery in their back for them to rise to the occasion, or it's going to be waiting on a miracle? Thank you for tuning in to Assem Sports. The Euro 2024 has been exciting, but I call it the Euro of the unknowns, the dark horses. Teams like Switzerland, teams like Austria are bound to cause a surprise. Are they going to be able to go to the final? Spain is obviously, clearly, miles ahead of everybody. The eloquent nature they play, the strategy, but also the game plan that they stick with. You could tell what they are about. And even against Georgia, when they lost 1-0 in the early minutes, there was no doubt in my mind that Spain were going to come back and beat Georgia. They are just too good. Thank you for tuning in to Assem Sports. Cristiano Ronaldo's Portugal is another favorite team that people tip might go all the way. They are playing against Slovenia today. France, Kylian Mbappe is playing against Romelu Lukaku's Belgium. Like you already know, the forecast 1.0. New Assem music available on all platforms. Click the link in the bio. More music on the way. This is Assem Sports. Euro 2024. France, Belgium, Portugal, Slovenia. Over there.